Now we are going to see the poetry Where the Mind is Without Fear. So this poetry is a prayer composed by Rabindranath Tagore. So Rabindranath Tagore has composed this poetry Where the Mind is Without Fear. It is a 35th song that has been mentioned in his famous book Gitanjali, which was awarded Nobel Prize for Literature in 1913. He wrote his poem during the British rule in India. So it was originally composed in Bengali language under the title Prarthana. It means prayer. He is praying to God to get freedom from cruel British rule. At the same time, he is making away all the countrymen to be courageous and struggle for freedom. He wants to instill courage in the hearts and minds of people, the people of India. His dream was to see India free from British rule. Through this poem, he wants to draw world's attention that great nation India was suffering a lot under the British rule, under the cruel British rule. So this is what, through this poetry, the poet Rabindranath Tagore is praying and giving message that the people of country must be free from this cruel British rule, and they must learn to accept, the people of India must learn to accept new changes in the society, in the Indian society. So let us see stanza by stanza. Look at the first line, where the mind is without fear and head is held high. In the first line, poet is praying to God that his countrymen should not get afraid to get freedom, and they must be free from suffering and persecution. He says head of the countrymen should be held high. They must feel proud and restore their dignity. So this is what the poet is praying in the first line. Look at the second line, where the knowledge is free. In the second line, the poet tells us about the importance of knowledge. Education has power to remove the ignorance and darkness. Only light of education can remove darkness from our life. Therefore, knowledge should be free and everyone should be allowed to gain knowledge or receive education. So, in the second line, the poet is praying as well as encouraging people to gain more and more knowledge. In the third line, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Okay, in this line, the poet says to the people of India, they must be united. And he is telling, at the same time he is telling the people of the world that there should be unity. There should not be division among people. The world or countries should not be divided into small pieces. There should be no division among the people on the basis of caste, creed, religion, color, race, rich, poor, and any sort of prejudices. These divisions should be removed from our country as well as from the world. Then only we can think of unity. Okay, the fourth line, where the words come out from the depths of truth. The poet warns that people of his country must speak truth from the depth of hearts. So this is what the poet is praying, that his countrymen, people of India, must learn to speak truth and speak truth. The fifth line, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. Through this line, the poet says everyone must work to reach goal, and goal is here freedom. They should strive to move every day towards perfection. So we must try, the poet is saying that people of India must try to move every day towards perfection. And here is a perfection means the final end of our life is to reach God, to see God. So the perfection is here used for God. So every day we must strive to be a good people so that we can reach the final end. Okay, the sixth line, where clear streams of reason has not lost its way into the dry desert sand of dead habit. In this line, he compares logical thinking to a clear stream and all traditional rituals and customs that are very, very harmful, like sand of desert and dead habit. The poet says that thinking and reasoning ability of people should not be covered by superstitious belief or old traditional belief. His countrymen should be led by new way of rational thinking and not by old beliefs that are harmful and useless for modern days. So this is what the poet is praying and giving the message same time to the people of India. The seventh line, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thought and action. Okay, here the thee word is old English word and it is used for God. So where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thought and action. In this line, the poet wants that the minds of his countrymen to be led forward by the Almighty God. He prays to Almighty God to broaden their outlook, thoughts, words, deeds, and whatever they do and think. They must be generous and open-minded to accept new changes, new thoughts, new learnings, new senses. So this is what the poet is praying through seventh line. Okay, look at the eighth line. And through this line, the poet is concluding his prayer, concluding his poetry. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. In the last line, poet says to God, he is praying to God, and he is saying God, Father. He is addressing God as Father, my Father, and asks him to awaken his country into a freedom like heaven, where there is a full freedom of good thoughts, good words, and good deeds. So the poet is praying to God that our country must be like heaven, where there is a peace, prosperity, no discrimination, and all sorts of goodness should prevail here. So this is what the poet is praying to God and at the same time is giving message to his countrymen. Thanks for watching my video.